Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are discuss here question number 161 to 180. This is the part 10th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. Now question number 161. Under section 167 of CRPC for detention for total period of 90 days during the investigation, expression for a term of imprisonment not less than mean. So the imprisonment for not less than 10 mean more than 10 year, up to 10 year, less than 10 year, both B and C. The question is very easy here, and I already expressed all the provision, almost all the provisions of section 167 of CRPC. If those who are not watching our previous video, I will provide these videos link in description box. So according to 167, answer is more than 10 year. Option A is correct here. Now question number 162. Under section 167 of CRPC, for offense other than those punishable with death, imprisonment for life, or imprisonment for a period not less than 10 year, the detention during investigation can be authorized for total period. So it is clear here, this question asked the other than. So according to section 67, the detention is provided in two ways. First 60 days, second one is 90 days. And there is also police remand for 15 days, maximum 15 days. It is 15 days. So 60 days for other offenses which are not belong to a capital punishment, imprisonment for life, or imprisonment for not less than 10 years. So for 60 days and 90 days for all the above offenses related to this punishment, and this is police remand. So answer is, according to this thing here, answer 60 days. So now answer is C here. Now question number 163. If investigation is not completed within 90 days or 60 days as the case may be, and accused in custody on the expiry of said period, accused is entitled to be discharged, released on bail, and or making an application for release on bail, released on bail without making an application for release on bail, and acquitted. So in this question, answer is here option B, release on bail after expiry of period of 90 or 60 days, the police report is not submitted before the court, so the accused is released on bail or making an application for released on bail. So answer is B here. Now question number 164. For a purpose of computation of period of 90 days, 60 days, as the case may be, for the purpose of section 162 subsection 2, 167 subsection 2 of CRPC. Option A here, the day of arrest of accused has to be excluded. Option B here, day on which the accused was remanded is to be excluded. Option C here, the day of arrest of accused and the day on which the accused was remanded, in if different, both have to be excluded. Option D here, the day of arrest of accused only has to be excluded, and the day on which the accused was remanded, even if a different, cannot be excluded. So answer is here option C, the day of arrest. Here first important, day of arrest of accused and day of on which the accused was remanded, if different, both have to be excluded. Both have to be excluded here. So option C is correct here. Now question number 165. An accused was arrested for offense under section 302 of IPC. It is punishment of murder. IPC on 1st January 2002 and remanded to judicial or police custody 2nd January 2002. Now for the purpose of section 167 subsection 2 of CRPC, in computing the period of 90 days, yes, there is a 302, it is a punishment for murder, and their punishment, minimum punishment, is life imprisonment. So the remand is here, so it is 90 days of imprisonment. It is computing and calculating option A here. The day of arrest, 1st January 2002, only has to be excluded and shall be computed, read with enforce section 2nd January 2002 when remanded, and thus 90 days shall fall on 1st April 2002. Now option B here. The day of arrest, 1st January 2002, and the day remanded, 2nd January 2002, both have been excluded. This is important here. And the 90 days shall fall on 2nd April 2002. So, according to previous question, both day of arrest and day of remand are excluded. So, answer is here. Option B is correct here. Now, question number. There is no need to read other options here. Option B is correct here. Now, question number 166. In the case tribal by magistrate as summon case, the investigation cannot be continued under section 167 subsection 5. The period of beyond a period of 6 months from the date of arrest of accused. Beyond the period of 6 months from the date of commission of offense. Beyond the period of maximum term of imprisonment prescribed for the offense from the date of accused. Beyond the period of maximum term of imprisonment prescribed for offense for the date of commission of the offense. So, according to this question, answer is beyond the period of 6 months from the date of the arrest of accused. So it is here the case trial by magistrate as summon case, the investigation cannot be continued. So according to section 167 subsection 5, the magistrate have power to stop, order to stopping. So it is, this provision is 167 subsection 5. So magistrate order to stopping further investigation. Investigation. And if until, so first of all, the magistrate stop the further investigation until the police officer satisfy the magistrate. Police officer's duty here to satisfy the magistrate. Satisfy the magistrate. Which thing is satisfy here? Ki there is a special reason. So second important point is special reason. Special reason. Which type of special reason? And for the interest of justice. So it is very important point here. There is a special reason, second point, and third point is in interest of justice. In interest of justice. To continue, for which things these provided here? To continue, which thing is continue here? Investigation is continue beyond the period of 6 months. Beyond the period of 6 months. So the main provision, section 167 subsection 5, is the magistrate in summon case, especially in summon case, to stop the investigation, order to the police officer, investigation officer, not police officer. But if investigation officer satisfy the magistrate, there is a first thing is important, satisfy the magistrate for a special reason. There is a special reason, that's why we cannot complete an investigation. And second is on the interest of justice. This is the power of magistrate. Interest of magistrate, think that this is the interest of justice. So in this condition, magistrate order to investigation officer to continue the investigation after the period of 6 months. Now come to our question here. So in this question, answer is here option A, beyond the period of 6 months from the date of arrest of accused. Now question number 167. The continuation of investigation in summon case, trial by magistrate beyond the period of 6 months from the date of arrest of the accused without the previous permission of the magistrate. This is very important question here. Shall render the entire investigation vitiate, it is vitiate here, and bad. The accused is liable to be discharged. Option B here, shall not be rendered the render the entire investigation, not render entire investigation, but bad, but accused is liable to be discharged. Option C here, shall not render entire investigation bad, but the prosecution can only rely on investigation so carry out, and the evidence so collected shall not be admissible. So it is clear here, option C is correct here. Such investigation after the period of 6 months, which things I provided, is not available in this option here. So after the period of 6 months without the permission of magistrate, the police officer conduct the investigation, so such investigation shall not be rendered entirely, but or not bad here, but bad here, but the prosecution cannot rely on investigation so carry out, and the evidence so collected shall not be admissible. These evidence are not admissible here. Now question number 168. After the completion of investigation, the police is to submit a final report, it is final report submit here, on to the magistrate. Under the magistrate is bound, option here important, is bound by conclusion drawn by the police, and accept the same if the police recommended that there is no sufficient ground for proceeding further investigation. Now option B, is not bound by the conclusion drawn by police and may order further investigation. Option C, may issue a process against the accused person, both B and C. Now answer is here, may issue a process against the accused, because the magistrate is not bound in the report of conclusion of the police report, and magistrate having power to may issue the process against the accused, where the in the favor of the police in the favor of accused and filing the final report. But in such, the magistrate is not bound such on some final report. Now question number 169. Upon the report being forwarded under section 173 subsection 2 of CRPC, the magistrate for dropping of proceeding before deciding not to taking a cognizance, the magistrate, option A here, must give notice to and provide informant an opportunity for being heard. Option B here, need not give a notice to and provide the informant an opportunity of being here at all. May and may not give a notice to and provide an informant an opportunity of being heard, and depending on the fact and circumstance, both B and C. Now I read here again question here, very important question is question number 169. Upon the report being forwarded under section subsection section 173 subsection 2 of CRPC, magistrate for dropping the proceeding, magistrate exclude the proceeding and magistrate stop the proceeding here, and before deciding not to take a cognizance of magistrate, before, because cognizance is taken by the magistrate under section 190 here, but in this section, this is under section 173, the police has submitting the police report before the magistrate, and after the submit receiving the police report, magistrate had decided to dropping the proceeding. In such decision, it must be give the notice to provide the informant and those who are informant, like in FIR or complaint case, to informant an opportunity to being heard. So this is the answer here, option A. There must be given the opportunity to the informant by the magistrate. Now question number 170. The order passing under section 125 CRPCR. So what is the provision of 125? This is very important section. This having a civil nature and substantive nature in Code of Criminal Procedure. So for 125 here, very important thing here, 125, this section is providing order for maintenance. So this is the order for maintenance. So whose maintenance here? First one is wife, second person here children, and third one important here parents. So these three persons having a maintenance from the court. So wife, children and parents. Now important here, the wife, so all these persons are unable to maintain himself. This is important thing, all these persons are unable to maintain. So in this section subsection 1, the wife unable to maintain himself or herself, sorry here herself, because this is woman, so it is herself. Now second one is minor child, second subsection 2 is minor child. So minor child or children, so whether it is legitimate or illegitimate, there is no concept of legity or illegity, there is no provision of legity or illegitimate, whether or married or not married, not concerned that there is married or not married. It is very important here, married or not married, not married. So minor child, either they are legitimate or illegitimate, either they are married or not married, having a right to get a maintenance from their parents. Or now option 3 here, subsection 3, major child. So the question is here, the major child, why the major child is covered under this section? Because if they are unable to maintain him or herself, because they are physically handicapped or mentally abnormal, injury is unable to maintain their abnormality, and they are injured, seriously injured, unable to maintain, injured person, injury is there, so these children are. But in this major or children's, married daughter is excluded. So here exclude person, which person is excluded here? Exclude married daughter, because after marriage of daughter, the husband is liable, not father is liable or mother is liable, there is husband is liable. So married daughter is not included in this provision. So married daughter, so married daughter not conclude here, including here. And last subsection 4 here, father and mother. father and mother. Parents also having the protection of getting the maintenance under section 125. So these persons are getting maintenance under this section. Now question number 170. The order passing under section 125 of CRPC, the summary nature but finally determine the right and obligation of parents. Option B, summary in nature and do not finally determine the right and obligation of a parent parties, which are to be finally determined by civil court. Option C, substantive in nature and finally determine the right and obligation of party. Option D, substantive in nature and are not a subject to determine of right of parties by a civil court. Now answer is here option B. The Code of Criminal Procedure section 125 is summarily in nature. It is a very fast procedure because it is the direct relation to the life and living of standard of the victim. So it is summarily in nature and do not finally determine the right and obligation of a party, which are to be finally determined by the civil court. So it is clear here, right and liabilities or obligation of a party is determined by the civil court, not determined in this section. This section is provide a fast remedy and to the victim or to the persons and who is able to get the maintenance under section 125. Sorry. Now question number 171. Section 125 CRPC provide a remedy by the way of summary procedure and which co-extensive with the civil liabilities under personal law. Option B, by the way of summary procedure which is co-extensive with the civil liabilities under a civil law. Option C, by the way of summary procedure which is not co-extensive with the civil liability under a personal law or civil law. Option D, both A and B. So here answer is option C is correct. By the way of summary procedure which is not co-extensive, these are not co-extensive with the civil liabilities under the personal law or civil law. Now question number 173. Section 125 of CRPC is applicable to Hindus, Muslim, Christian, all of the person belonging to all religions. So it is clear here option D is correct. Hindu, Muslim and Christian, all of the religions. There is no provision of a particular religion. The basic question is it is declared in many cases, the Daniel Latifi versus Union of India and Muhammad Ahmed versus Shah Banu case. So Shah Banu case is very important here. Everyone should know this case, Shah Banu Begum is 1985. So, and another important case is Daniel Latifi versus Union of India. Daniel Latifi, L-A-T-I-F-I, Latifi, and versus Union of India. And this case is belong to 2001. So, answer is here in this question 173, option D. Now question number 174. The Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 1986 deal with the claim of maintenance by Muslim women. Option B, claim of maintenance by a Muslim divorced woman. Claim of maintenance by the children of marriage, the marriage with the said Muslim divorced woman. Option D, both B and C. So in this question answer is here option B, claim for maintenance of Muslim divorced woman. So with this act it clearly shows that the woman protection of right of divorced. So it is claim for maintenance of a Muslim divorced woman. Now question number 175. Under section 125 of CRPC, who cannot be ordered to provide maintenance? First option here, a father. Option B here, husband. Option C here, a daughter. Option D is here, none of the above. So it is clear here, all these person is liable to pay the maintenance, either father, husband, daughter. So option D is correct here, none of the above, because who cannot be ordered to provide maintenance? So all these persons are ordered to provide maintenance. This is very important case here. Everyone should write there, Bijay Manohar Arbat versus Kasi Rao. Bijay Manohar Arbat versus Kasi Rao is declared by the Supreme Court that daughter is liable to maintain their parents, her parents. So daughter is also liable here to present, to pay their parents for maintenance. So learn here this Bijay Manohar. So I write here, there's a space, so I take the another space here. Case here, Bijay Manohar, Manohar Arbat, Arbat versus Kasi, Kasi Rao. This case is shows that the daughter is liable to maintain her parents. So it is clear here, daughter is also liable here, not only husband or father. Question number 176. Where the husband has obtained a decree of divorce against the wife on the order of a desertion. So it is desertion here. Under section 125, it is not barred. This is important point here. Not barred for the wife to claim maintenance against the husband, for the wife to claim maintenance against the husband may be barred for the wife to claim maintenance against the husband. Option D, either A or B. So I read here again question, where the husband is obtained a decree of divorce against the wife on the ground of husband, under section 125, it is not barred for the wife to claim. The wife is not bound by it, is not restrict or restrained to claim the maintenance from the husband. Their husband is getting the renounce and the desertion, but the woman has right to get a maintenance from their husband. If he is not unable, she get the compensation, she get the maintenance from his property, but she is able to get a maintenance from husband. There is no restriction, any restriction to restrain her maintenance right. So option A is correct here. Question number 177. In proceeding under section 125 CRPC, option A, restrict the proof of marriage is necessary. Standard of proof is very high as required in proceeding under the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. The prima facie proof showing that the parties are living as husband and wife is sufficient. Prima facie. The prima facie proof showing that the parties are living on husband and wife is not sufficient, and something more is required. So according to section 125, the prima facie proof showing that the party are living as husband and wife is sufficient. So option C is correct here. Now question number 178. Under section 125 of CRPC, the father and the mother, the parent can claim maintenance from son. Yes, it is clear here. Daughter, stepson, both son and daughter. So it is clear here, option B is correct here. Both son and daughter. Now 179. The expression mother under section 125 subsection 1 mean and referable to, this is important here question, the real and natural mother, step mother generally both A and B, neither A nor B. So it is clear here, the mother include real and natural mother, not a step mother. So answer option A is correct here. In previous question, I take here, look at here, option A, son, daughter, and option answer is correct here, both son and daughter, not stepson. Why? Because if this there is a son and father getting two or more wife, so son is not liable to feed them and to provide the maintenance to all these wives, all his wives, in the condition when he is unable to maintain him, her. So that is the reason here. So the mother is referred to real mother or natural mother. Now final question of this video, question number 180. Section 188 of CRPC provide for extraterritorial jurisdiction over Indian citizen, non-citizen, option C, foreigners, all of the above. So section 188, this is section is provided the offense, section 188, this section is 188, offense is committed outside, it is outside. So which is outside? The territory of India, outside the territory of India. So subsection 1 here, 188, by the citizen of India. First, if the any citizen of India outside the, he is under the jurisdiction of Indian court, so outside the India, doing an offense, whether high sea or anywhere, whether a high sea, any part of the world, if he is not world, he is at the moon and he committing any offense, so such Indian citizen is trialed by the Indian court, not the foreign court. This is provided in section 188 subsection 1. So any Indian, whether he is living anywhere in whole universe, and if he doing any offense, if he done any offense, such person is tribal in under Indian court. Now subsection 2 here, any person not being a Indian, so person not being Indian citizen, but on any ship, aircraft, or any vessels, so I only take here ship, on any ship, and which is registered under the India, Indian Act, or flagged under the India, so such person doing any offense in the ship in which is flagged under the India is triable in Indian court. This is the territorial jurisdiction, this is the extraterritorial jurisdiction of the Indian courts. So now come to the question of 180. So according to description, it is all of the above. So this provision is describe here the citizen and non-citizen and foreigners. So answer is here all of the above. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Please share this video to your friends. Thank you for watching. Thank you.